Sehr geehrter Herr Präsident, ich schreibe Ihnen diesen Brief im Haus meiner
Dear
Eltern.
Dear Mr. President, I'm writing this letter to you from my parents' house, from the house in which they were murdered. Next to the table from where I write these lines, my father's chair, the chair in which they sat him, facing Mecca, and in the 70th year of his life, repeatedly stabbed him and tore out his heart, a pure heart that always loved Iran and the people of Iran. His blood has now dried on the carpet and the stains have paled. The echo of the screams of pain my parents cried out still fill the entire house and resound again in my own sorrowful heart. Yours sincerely, Parastu Fruhar.
Hochachtungsvoll, Parastu Fruhar.
Iran, 1998. A country torn apart. Tradition and a new beginning. Religion and politics. Totalitarian oppression and the rallying cry of freedom and human rights. The various factions in this authoritarian, theocratic country are confronting one another with uncharacteristic openness. And this is the latest beacon of hope, Mohammad Khatami. Like an Islamic Gorbachev, many hope he might be able to democratize the system and break the conservative mullah's hold on power. Surprisingly, he has just been elected president of the government by 70% of the population. In this time of optimism and hope, we visited two legendary opposition leaders in Iran, Dariush and Parvaneh Fruhar. They openly criticized the authority of the mullahs, just as they fought 30 years ago against the dictatorship of Reza Pahlavi with his notorious secret police, the Savak.
اون نشریه پنهانی جبهه ملی رو در می آوردم خبرنامه جبهه ملی به من گفتن تو هم باید که مخفی بشی بچه ها رو گذاشته بودیم منزل مادر و خودمون مشغول فعالیت بودیم که چیز بهتری بسازیم که متاسفانه نشد
The political ideal Mohammad Mossadegh, who as prime minister in the 50s, nationalized the Iranian oil industry and was then toppled from power with the help of the CIA. Next to his portrait, pictures of their grandchildren who live in Germany, with daughter Parastu, a successful artist, and son Arash.
I love Germany because all the children are there.
An diesem Wochenende hatten die noch nicht angerufen.
They hadn't called us yet on that weekend. It was Sunday afternoon and I was still expecting the phone to ring.
در را بسته دیدم و چند نفر مقابل در بودند. گفتم که در زدیم گفتن نیستند گفتم که شما با آقای فروهر قرار دارید گفتن بله گفتم محال آقای فروهر با کسی قرار داشته باشه و او را پشت در بگذاره
و یکی دیگر از دوستان صبح ساعت 10 زنگ زده و کسی جواب نداده گفتم این غیر ممکنه به خاطر اینکه داریوش و فروهر زندگیش یک نظمی داشت دوچاره این بی نظمی ها را بر نمیتابید.
من چون خیلی با آقای فروهر نزدیک بودم نگران شدم، گفتم به یکی از اون جوانهایی که اونجا بود برو در رو باز کن ببینیم چیست، چه خبره داخل. اون جوان از دیوار بالا آمد، در بزلندی هم داره اینجا، آمد در رو باز کرد، دیگه غروب شده بود دیگه تقریبا، اون چراغ توی حیاط رو روشن کرد.
I started trying to call Iran, my parents' house. I tried several times. Nobody answered the phone. I sent a fax, no answer.
من به اتفاق اون افرادی که اونجا بودن آمدیم به داخل و وقتی داخل ساختمان شدم آقای فروهر روی این صندلی در حالی که سینه‌اش خون‌آلود بود افتاده بود و سر به عقب. بعد من از دوستان پرسیدم که پروانه کجاست؟ چند نفر رفتن به طبقه بالا آمدن گفتن پروانه را هم کشتند، پروانه در روی زمین افتاده بود.
Dann habe ich einen engen Freund von den beiden in Paris angerufen.
Then I called a friend of the couple in Paris. When he answered the telephone, he was crying.
Ich habe gefragt, was ist da?
I said, what's wrong?
Er hat mir gesagt,
he told me they'd been attacked, and I asked, what happened? At first I was only thinking of my father, because he was the one who was always more... I always saw the danger to him and not to my mother. I asked whether my father was in the hospital, and he said, it's over. And then I asked, is my father dead? And he said, it's not just your father. And that's when I knew my parents had been murdered.
Er meinte, es ist nicht nur dein Vater. Und da wusste ich, dass meine Eltern ermordet worden sind.
The Führers had not always been in conflict with the Islamic rulers. When the people revolted against the Shah, the battle-experienced boss of the Party of the Iranian People was one of the leading spokesmen and organizers of the broad alliance opposing the dictatorship.
اعلام فرماندار نظامی کرد و به گیر و به بند بسیار زیاد و کشداری که در خیابان ژاله و میدان ژاله رخ داد.
The martyrs of Maidan Jaleh had ignited a signal fire. Every attempt by the emperor, who was supported by the United States and other Western countries, to quell the uprising through bloodshed only made things worse. The blood of those killed was the clearest proof of the regime's cruelty and of the righteousness of the rebellion. In the Shiite universe in which many Iranians live, all those who were killed were considered to be disciples of Hussein, a grandson of Muhammad, who in the old days was deceitfully murdered near Karbala and robbed of his political birthright as a descendant of the Prophet. A macabre cult of death, swaying between an irrational guilt complex and fanatical hatred toward followers of other beliefs, without which it would also be difficult to explain the bloodbath that took place in the home of the Führers.
Die wollten das, die Körper mir nicht zeigen. Und habe ich gesagt,
they didn't want to show me the bodies. But I said, I have to see them. Otherwise, I won't sign and take custody of them. They took a while. They didn't want to allow it. Of course, they knew what condition the bodies were in. But I insisted. Then they not only showed me the faces, but also the upper bodies of them both. And I could tell, those were two torsos that had been disfigured by stab wounds, both of them. I can never forget that sight. I was just completely destroyed. Here were the bodies of a 70-year-old man and a 60-year-old woman. It was very disturbing. My father had been stabbed in the chest 15 times, and my mother had been stabbed in the bosom 24 times. And what you could see was utter destruction. That's part of my memory of my parents. It's not just the pretty smiles and these people so full of zest for life that I remember. It's also their tragic end. That image is part of my parents' life. That is the tragic fate of two wonderful people who wanted nothing more than democracy. I could not permit myself to close my eyes to that.
When the Shah was deposed in February of 1979 and Khomeini returned from exile, Dariush Fruha was also a passenger on that historic plane, a new era for Iran. But the old man who set foot in his homeland leaning on the arm of the pilot was underestimated by most of his initial allies, an error with serious consequences. Fruha had spent 14 years in the Shah's prisons. Now, he became Minister of Labor in the first cabinet of national unity. Another cabinet member from the National Religious Iranian Freedom Movement was Ibrahim Yazdi, the foreign minister at the time.
Fruha's party, the party of the Iranian nation, was entirely dedicated to the nationality, not to the Islamicity or to the religiosity of our culture. To me, it's okay. In many cases, we have cooperated with each other on the area of the national priority, although not in the area of religiosity.
با وجودی که اعتقاد راسخی به اسلام داشت ولی تحلیلش این بود که دین باید از دولت جدا باشه ولی از سیاست نه برای اینکه انسان از سیاست نمیتونه رهایی داشته باشه.
After a few months in the government, Fruha soon finds himself in opposition to the new religious rulers.
جمع‌بندی کنم من به هیچ وجه از شرکت در انقلاب پشیمانی ندارم و به هنگام هم همه نیروی خودم رو گذاشتم که از به کجراه گفتادن انقلاب جلوگیری کنم به همین دلیل مدت‌ها زندگی پنهانی و سپس زندان جمهوری اسلامی رو پشت سر گذاشتم و در اون بحبوحه کشتارها و چهره دژمی که به جمهوری اسلامی داده شده بود با تکیه به همان عاطفه‌هایی که عنوان کردم شخص امام خمینی دستور آزادی مردم داد.
When Khomeini died in 1989, the middle class and his socialist allies of the early days had been removed from power, murdered, or forced to flee. The country was completely in the hands of the religious leaders. The purges carried out by the Islamic Republic proved to be just as murderous as the terror perpetrated by the Shah in the months of the revolution. The pious men are also feared abroad. In Paris, their killer commandos slit the throat of the former Prime Minister Bakhtiar with a kitchen knife. Kurdish leader Khasamlu is shot and killed during peace talks in Vienna. His successors were shot down by automatic gunfire in a restaurant in Berlin.
ما هدفمون این بود که مردم به آزادی برسن، به استقلال برسن، به عدالت اجتماعی برسن. متاسفانه اون چیزی که الان اصلا پیدا نمیشه عدالت اجتماعی است، چون فاصله بین مردم بسیار 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 زیادتر از گذشته شده. امروز یک گروه هستند که از سیری نمیدونن چه بکنن و گروه عظیمی دچار گرسنگی مفرد. و ما خودمون رو مسئول میدونیم. به همین دلیل میکوشیم شاید وضع بهتری بدیم. ما میگفتیم تو این چارچوب کاری نمیشه که انجام بشه. ما میگفتیم یه تغییر بنیادی و اساسی باید داده بشه.
He sat in that chair, just as you see it here, facing southwest. I said to Parastu, he's facing Mecca.
Then they turned him toward Mecca. All for religious reasons. Someone who does a thing like that believes he's serving God in doing so.
I think they did that to frighten other opponents, but they didn't succeed. Others in the opposition were supposed to think they would suffer the same fate as Fruha. But when 500,000 people took to the streets for the funeral, everyone knew that the regime's efforts had failed.
میتونم بگم اگه غلو نباشه تهران در مراسم تشییع جنازه او شرکت کرد. از شهرستان ها، از کردستان، از بلوچستان، همه اونایی که عاشقش بودن و این عاشق اونا بود همه اومده بودن. یه خیابونی که نمیدونم چند کیلومتر، 5-6 کیلومتر شاید.
جمعیت انبوه بود و همه می گفتن درود بر مصدق، سلام بر فروهر و سرود ایران رو می خوندن. ما این دو رو تا میدان بهارستان رسوند.
His enemy, they made a drastic mistake by killing him. He became a hero of Iranian struggle. He was a sick man, he could go anyway. But they made a mistake. And the way that they killed him was very brutal and humane. He killed him in a very, very barbaric way. He and his wife. There is no logic to justify, there is no way to justify that kind of killing. Only that reflect how deeply they were opposing him. They couldn't tolerate it.
In the following weeks, there were more murder victims. The writers Pouyandé and Motari. A secret death squad was apparently trying to paralyze the reform movement through fear tactics.
10 days after the murder, our parents' home was returned to us. The looting, they had gone through everything that was... They removed all political documents. They practically erased my parents' entire life from the house. It was as if they had completely confiscated the lives of my parents, and in such a disrespectful way. I went through the house, and the whole time I kept asking the security officer who was there, why? What was this all about? What was it supposed to achieve? And he couldn't even look me in the face, just kept repeating, we didn't do this. I'm only responsible for handing it over. This was not our doing.
Das waren wir nicht. Ich bin nur für die Übergabe zuständig. Das waren wir nicht.
No one in Iran really expected the series of murders to be investigated. But then something totally unexpected happened.
Her house was bugged by the Ministry of Intelligence and Security and other organizations. The guy who came in the morning to change the tape and put new tape picked up the tape from last night and listened. And he heard that they are shouting, fighting, and he realized they are killing Furuhar and his wife.
And it just so happened that the wiretapping expert was not a conservative, but a supporter of the newly elected reform president, Hatami.
He took this cassette or copied the cassette and took it to Khatami's office and told them this is the story. Khatami listened to the tape and his national security advisor, Mr. Ali Rabi'i, he also heard, and they summoned Mr. Kazemi, the second man in the ministry, third man in the ministry. And Kazemi confessed. Kazemi said, we did it under the instruction of minister. And we thought we are going to be, you know, greeted with promotion and welcome and so and so.
I have to give the credit to Mr. Khatami. He was the president. He was informed. He had the information that the Ministry of Information, Intelligence Service, has done it. He had either two choices. Either he himself come announce, or back door, beyond the door, push the ministry to come and say, yes, we have done it.
A few weeks after the murder, President Hatami addressed the public himself.
He succeeded in that line, that the Ministry of Information, the intelligence, announced, accepted the responsibility, and said, yes, we have done it. And said, Pat said, a group of the employees, agents, have done it independently.
In the spring of 1999, a few of the actual perpetrators were arrested. Their interrogations are recorded on a videotape that was smuggled out. Pressure was put on the captives using threats, blows, and wild sexual rumors and accusations. They are to claim the murders were organized by American and Israeli secret agents in an effort to discredit the Islamic Republic. The most important of the accused criminals dies in jail, supposedly by drinking a depilatory lotion. His incriminating statements are subsequently struck from the official record. In his place, his widow is arrested and beaten until she makes new confessions. Ultimately, the process was transferred to the military prosecutor, which meant it was no longer subject to civil or official control. The families of the victims refused to participate in the farce of a secret court case.
The people who actually inflicted those stab wounds on my parents and the person who had strangled the writers, these people were sentenced to death in accordance with Islamic law. That means blood for blood. Retaliatory execution was their punishment, death payment. But the court said that the victim's family members must make the final decision. That means they conducted a court case we did not recognize or agree with. But then they put the burden of judgment in this case on our shoulders. We are now responsible for saying whether we demand the death penalty for people who were really just henchmen. We had to reach that decision.
And yet, according to the sentence, there was a catch to the execution of her mother's murderers. Because under Islamic law, the life of a woman is only worth half as much as that of a man.
The immediate family members may, after paying half of the blood money to the family of this man, demand a death sentence.
Blood money, for the price difference between the life of a man and a woman, demanded by an archaic law that was written prior to the year 1400 and hardly modernized since.
What kind of a system is that? Where the life of my mother, who fought for democracy her entire life, such a wonderful, upstanding woman, a lovable and loving human being, is only worth half as much as that of the man who murdered her. What kind of a value system is that?
پرونده چه وقت مختوم است؟ دو طرف داره هر دادگاهی دو طرف داره. این طرف میگه آقا من حقمو نگرفتم، اون طرف میگه مختوم است. در نتیجه مختوم نیست.
Meine Eltern waren gegen Todesstrafe.
My parents were opposed to the death penalty. They announced that publicly in a political memo. They wanted the death penalty to be abolished. How could we demand these people be put to death?
Wie konnten wir überhaupt Todesstrafe verlangen?
Many of the old agents that were put in prison, they were subject to torture in order to extract from them some confession that we did it on our own. That event has caused the ministry to modify their manner. Those extremists who wanted to commit the same things, they have created a parallel intelligence service outside of the ministry to continue the same behavior.
Allahu Akbar!
These kinds of parallel structures employing brutal violence to support the conservative rulers without requiring state authorities to become involved are quite common in the Islamic Republic. A demonstration against the great Satan, America, and their British allies, who have just attacked the holy cities of Najaf and Karbala in Iraq. At Revolution Square, the regime's civil militias march, having been brought in by the busload and paid a few tuman to make noise. That was the official part of the event. But then we witnessed the unofficial part, which was not intended to be recorded by foreign cameras. Riotous gangs of Hezbollah and the black shirts of the Baziji paramilitary forces have filled the street in front of the British embassy. Security forces move into position just a stone's throw from the building. Mullahs and secret service personnel choreograph the collusive dance between police and demonstrators.
Murder,
enraged followers, in the words of the official report, attacked the British consulate in a spontaneous action. Security forces dispatched to the site had difficulty retaining them. The oppressed and persecuted Shiites were always known to be masters of disguise. Now that they are in power, the rulers of the Islamic Republic have revealed themselves to be true masters of deceit and hypocrisy.
We found out that there was a tray here with 11 teacups, but the tea had never been served. That means Parvane made a pot of tea for these people.
In part of the tape, you hear one of the guy over there. He is calling Hajaga, or the minister, or his deputy, Mr. Pur Mohammadi, and telling him, we did it, we finished it, but unfortunately we did his wife as well. You hear that. This is what you hear. After they finish, they are talking, and that was the reason Khatami from the beginning said, the minister and his deputy, they were involved.
Die Aufklärung Arbeit richtet sich auch gegen so ein System.
The detective work that needs to be done is not just about a few criminals. The entire system needs to be investigated. The subject of the investigation should be the fundamental way of thinking that justifies executing people for religious or political reasons. That's the subject that needs to be addressed.
For 5 years, the investigation of the murder of the Frühars and the others was in the hands of this man, Ayatollah Shahroudi, head of the Iranian justice apparatus. June 2004. This is the first session of the newly elected parliament and the system that Parastu Frühar suspects was behind the murders. The regime of the conservative mullahs has just regained the majority using dubious methods. The rejection of more than 3,000 reform candidates by the religious Guardian Council turned the hopes of the liberal forces into mere illusions. Now, the aggressive heckling of the Islamist zealots once again dominates the Majlis. The leader of the parliamentary commission to investigate the Secret Service murders was among those no longer allowed to run for parliament. The report was never completed.
در این حال در رسیدگی که در کمیسیون اصل 90 ما انجام دادیم از یک مرحله خاصی به لحاظ ساختار کارمون و حدود قدرتی که کمیسیون میتونست اون رو اعمال کنه امکان جلو رفتن و رسیدگی جامع و کاملی به این پرونده بر ما نبود.
The highest person who knew about the whole project, about everything, was Durri Najaf Abadi, the minister, former minister Mr. Ali Fallahian, because the project started on the, when he was minister.
مسئولین واقعی و کسانی که واقعا سازمان دهنده این جریان بودند به طور اصولی برای ما مشخص نشد.
Mr. Khamenei ordered that the minister just go to a judge and swear to God three times that he was not involved and that's enough. So he swore to God God is not involved and they gave him you know exemption from any further prosecution. And now he is the can you imagine? He is now prosecutor general in Iran, the minister.
ما به جای خطر نرفتیم اصلا. ما به مرحله خطر اصلا نرفتیم.
The annual commemoration of the death of revolutionary leader Khomeini is one of the most important religious and political demonstrations staged by the conservative leadership. The mourning of the deceased revolutionary leader borrows heavily from similar rituals, such as the ecstatic self-inflicted punishment in honor of Hussein, the murdered descendant of the Prophet and founding father of Shiaism. The people beating themselves on the chest and head as a symbol of their mourning and compassion are the reserve army of the religious leaders, ready to strike out with their fists or even daggers in a pitiless aggression against anyone who thinks or believes differently than they do, anytime their leaders tell them to do so. The fifth anniversary of the death of the Fuhrers is also commemorated by friends and followers of the victims. For them, it is not just a ceremony of mourning, but also a political demonstration. Among the international camera teams and press photographers are also spies, agents of the State Secret Service, to which the murderers themselves also belonged. Last year, the assembly came under massive attack by gangs of thugs belonging to Hezbollah, the Party of God. No anti-Islamic slogans are heard here today. Even the harshest critics of the government carefully emphasize that they believe in a just and tolerant Islam whenever they criticize the religious leaders. Significantly, this service in memory of the Fuhrers is taking place in a mosque, although the couple were both very secular in their views. This setting affords them some protection from religious fanatics. However, when Paris du Fuhrer stands up to make a speech, the simple fact that a woman is allowed to speak here borders on sacrilege.
در پزشک قانونی تهران پوشش رویش را کنار زدند تا برای آخرین بار ببینمش. کنار او همراهش هم رزمش پروانه، اما چشمهای نیمه باز این یگان زن همچنان با شوقی به دور دستها خیره مانده بود، انگار از برای خشونتی که بر او رفت در آخرین لحظه های حیات نیز چشم به رویاهای ابدیش داشت، به رویای آزادی ایران.
بله، من دکتر مصدق هم بعد از اینکه ما ازدواج کردیم در نامه‌ای که برای شادباش برای ما نوشتن درش این رو تذکر دادم که خداوند نجار نیست ولی در و تخته رو به هم جور میکنه و این واژه همه عمر باعث سربلندی منه که واقعا ما ازدواجمون علاوه بر این که عاشقانه بوده یه ازدواج سیاسی بوده و خدا رو شکر که تونستیم که نگهش داریم.
Das Bild hatte meine Mutter am fünften Hochzeitstag mein Vater, der im Gefängnis war.
On their fifth wedding anniversary, my mother sent this picture to my father, who was in jail at the time, along with a poem in which she writes that she wants them to stay together for the rest of their lives. And she writes, even if they should tear my body apart, I will never allow them to tear me away from you.
Up to the very end, the government of the Islamic Republic feared the political charisma of the Führers. In a special meeting of the National Security Council, it was ruled that the murder victims could not be buried near the grave of Mossadegh, and also not in the garden of their own home. So now their friends come here to Behezhd-e Zahra, the sprawling municipal cemetery of Tehran. And although they are accustomed to singing, they defiantly sing the former, now forbidden, national anthem. As long as the earth continues to turn, the lyrics say, the light of God will illuminate our path. But the light of God can be very deceptive. Sometimes even murderers believe they are following it.